নমস্কাৰ স্বাগতম জনাইছো মিডিয়া দিনৰ ষ্টুডিঅ' তোমাৰ অস্মিতা আৰু ইতিমধ্যে আমি দেখুৱাই আছো যে জ্যেষ্ঠ সাংবাদিকৰে বাৰ্তালাপ কৰিছে আজি মুখ্যমন্ত্ৰী ডক্টৰ হিমন্ত বিশ্ব শৰ্মাই আমি পোনপটীয়া সম্প্ৰচাৰলৈ লৈ গৈছো
এইটোতহে তেওঁলোকৰ পাইলট ছিকিউৰিটি আহিব নালাগে দেন কাৰণ নহ'লে আৰু দুখন বাঢ়ি যায় চ' দে শ্বুড নট ব্ৰিং দেয়াৰ পাইলট এস্কৰ্ট অন মাই এণ্টৰেজ তেওঁলোকে দহ মিনিট দেৰি আহিব বাট সেইটোত আহিব নোৱাৰে আৰু প্ৰবেবলি লাহে লাহে উই আৰ মুভিং টুৱাৰ্ডছ দেট আইডিয়েল চিটুৱেশ্যন যে চি এম এ উইদাউট ছিকিউৰিটি নোহোৱাকৈ গাড়ীতে ঘূৰক বাট ফৰ ডেট উই নিড টু হেভ টু থ্ৰী চাম মোৰ নিগচিয়েশ্যন মোৰ ডিছকাশ্যন পিচ ফাইনেলি আহিব লাগিব বাট উই আৰ অন ৰাইট ডিৰেকশ্যন আমি এটা ৰাইট ডিৰেকশ্যনত মুভ কৰি আছো আপোনালোকে সুধিব পাৰে
I'll start with the peace initiative that we have spoken about. You are hoping that 2022 would be peaceful. I just want to know what are the last hurdles that you have to clear. And since you have been also consulted by the government on the NSA Naga affair, so are you also including, hoping for a same peaceful state in the entire Northeast?
Two things, that our last hurdle is Alpha. If you exclude Alpha, then every militant organization has deposited their weapons. I will not use the word surrender. They have deposited their weapons. And as I have said with my opening remark, the tribal insurgency has come to an end. Alpha, from my personal interaction with various people who are directly or indirectly in touch with Sri Paresh Borua, it is clear that he also wants a negotiated settlement. Government of Assam or Government of India also wants a negotiated settlement. But only stumbling block is the demand for sovereignty. So I think we are working towards creating a new position where both the party actually do not feel it very difficult to talk. So the issue of sovereignty is a stumbling block, and that is one. On Nagaland, the approach of Honorable Prime Minister and Honorable Home Minister of India is very, very positive. The formation of committee and with a clear deadline of 45 days regarding withdrawal or partial or full withdrawal of APSA is a very, very important step which central government has taken. So I think with that, lot of confidence building will be there will be lot of confidence, and that will help in addressing other issues also.
তেওঁলোকে আপুনি চৰকাৰত দায়িত্বভাৰ লোৱাৰ পিছত তেওঁলোকে প্ৰতি মাহত বা ছমাহত তেওঁলোকে যুদ্ধ বিৰতি একপক্ষীয় যুদ্ধ বিৰতি ইউনিলেটাৰেল চিজ ফায়াৰ তেওঁলোকৰ ফালৰ পৰা আগবঢ়াই আহিছে চ' সেইটো এটা আপুনি এটা পজিটিভ ইতিবাচক এটা তেওঁলোকৰ পদক্ষেপ পজিশ্যনিং বুলি ক'ব পাৰে নেকি
চাওক মই আগতে কৈছোঁ যে মোৰ হৈ বা আমাৰ চৰকাৰ হৈ যিখিনি মানুহে আলফাৰ সেনাধ্যক্ষ পৰেশ বৰুৱাৰ লগত কথা পাতি আছে তেখেতসকলৰ পৰা মই যিটো ফিডবেক পাইছোঁ ডেট হি ইজ ভেৰি ভেৰি পজিটিভ কিন্তু আপোনালোকে এটা বস্তু চাব লাগিব যে ডিমাণ্ড ফৰ ছুভেৰেণ্টি যিটো তেখেতসকল আৰু আমাৰ মাজত এটা নন নিগচিয়েটিং পজিশ্যনলৈকে লৈ যায় সেইটো আমি কেনেকৈ ব্ৰেক কৰিব পাৰোঁ তাৰ বাবে আমাৰ চিন্তা চৰ্চা চলি আছে আৰু আলফাৰ যিটো ইউনিটাৰেল চিজ ফায়াৰ দেট ইজ এ ভেৰি ভেৰি পজিটিভ ষ্টেপ আৰু যদি আপোনালোকে ইফ ইউ লুক ভেৰি ক্ল'জলি ফ্ৰম দ্য গভৰ্ণমেণ্ট ছাইড ইভেন গভৰ্ণমেণ্ট হেজ অলছো নট টেকেন এনি পজিশ্যন ইন লাষ্ট 8 মান্থছ টু ডিষ্টাৰ্ব দেট পিচ যদি আলফা ইউনিটাৰেল চিজ ফায়াৰ মুখেদি বা থ্ৰ' ষ্টেটমেণ্ট দিছে গভৰ্ণমেণ্ট অলছো বাই ইটছ একশ্যন আমি আমাৰ কাম কাজৰ মাজেদি উই হেভ অলছো শ্ব'ন a positive response or positive inclination towards his unilateral ceasefire effort. That is why last 8 months you have not seen a direct conflict with Alpha and other paramilitary or police forces. But having said that, because we are a constitutional government, kunuba lorata jodi alpha jo ami khobor pao ba korobat jodi korobat demand notice aye, we have to act because we are here to preserve and protect the life and liberty of the people. But within that also, the last 8 months Paresh Borua dangoriya jimankhini khodissa dekhuaise Bharat sarkar aru Ahom sarkareu equally himane khodissa ami dekhuaisu aru moi bhabu je this bahut enekua complicated issue resolve korar agote you have to go very slow and careful way. So moi bhabu it is a beginning of an end, mane eta peaceful situation hobo goi. That beginning has been now there. Beginning to ami dekha paisu. I do not know. I do not want to put 2022-23. But moi bhabu je etia jitu eta positioning duita party loise. This should not reverse. Moi bhabu je hostile situation eta ahomot etia nohoi goi. We are seeing some kind of beginning of a peace. Now, when it will mature, it is a complicated situation. He is there in jungle from 1984-82. And Assam police has also in warpath since then. So, it is very, very difficult and complicated situation. But even then, I dare to say that a beginning of end has been seen. The eta khekhor arambhoni eta ami dekha paisu.
When you say...
Let us address Wasbida, then we'll go to that.
Okay. You have said that the Irau tribal insurgency is almost over in Assam.
What happens tomorrow? What will be the government's stand if a new insurgent group is formed? Are you going to start negotiating again? Because that will encourage insurgency. What is your stand? And I've got another question, which I will ask as soon as you finish.
Was been an important point which highlighted in my introductory speech that tribal insurgency to Amar initiative of Heguanai. It was the decision of tribal people that Amiaru insurgency kaku koribo nidiu. Very, very important difference. Jodi government aru NDFB major negotiation holeten. Government aru DLNR major decision holeten. Government aru Karbi or logot. Decision and then it would have been difficult. But this peace is result of a very, very tenuous hard work of the civil society. And now tribals are determined that amar yat ami aru kaku militancy koribo nidiu aru ami yat blood set nibisaru. When civil society are so firmly with you, then I do not see any eruption of tribal insurgency unless we inflict some injustice to them. Ami jodi kiba teolukok ako ebar eta injustice inflict koridiu, jitu result aji ami paisu. Moi keteba kao je the chauvinist mentality has paid us a huge. Ami jodi ahomor mainstream or manukheni janajati lokokor logot mili thakibo khuju. We do not show chauvinism over them, that you are a second class citizen, we are first class citizen. Amar jodi mindset to bodli na jai, last 10-15 bochor ahomiya manuhor jitu mindset ase, if we continue with that mindset, I do not see eruption of any tribal insurgency.
My last question, you have given a very positive picture of the state, which we are very happy to hear it from you in 2021. You have said that there are large-scale progress as far as the social sector schemes are concerned, capital-intensive schemes are concerned. That means there is a lot of infrastructure development projects going on. Now my question is, obviously you have a lot of plans in mind. I'd like to hear it from you. What are the steps you're going to take for generating livelihood options, self-employment schemes, so that you don't have to give grants or social sector grants to the people so that they can survive on their own? What is your plan?
The primary aim is the self-sufficiency. If you see that we could have added another 40,000 crore in our annual GDP, if we could have self-sufficient in agriculture, horticulture and dairy. So state government entire focus is to ensure that we become self-sufficient. Jate ami ahomot self-sufficient hobo paru, dairy, meat, poultry, krihi, gutekhini. Heitu jodi ami hobo paru, tetale automatically there will be livelihood. 1 lakh employment government sector. We are taking up the self-help group movement and the self-employment initiative. Aru eta ami khub kam hatot loisu, the maximum recruitment in central paramilitary forces and Indian army. I am taking regular advice from the distinguished gentlemen who are serving in very high post in Indian army from Assam. We are in regular discussion. Today in cabinet we have sanctioned a very important project on this line. Apnaluke Kaliba Porohi, whenever my colleague will address press apnaluke gom pabo. Aru ahomot unemployed loi pelai, livelihood loi pelai, there was a issue. Amar kono employment exchange register nasile. Ami jeta kon je 25 lakh, this 25 lakhs is a cumulative figure. Karon, we had a manual system of registration. Kuno bai jodi sakori pai nam to kata na jai. So it was a very difficult system. Eibar ami je kolu je all renewal and application should happen through computer. Ei bosor notun unemployed lora amar logot register korise 1,56,000 in last 8 months. So that shows moi generally moi bhabu je ami jiman project kori asu unemployment, that kind of unemployment is not here in Assam. Teneko ata mur bhabibo mon jai, but we'll wait up to 31st March to give a solid data. Yar logot ami kisuman kam korisu. It is a employment exchange or lorabilak register hobo. Now we are in touch with various employment based web portal. Suppose Naukri.com omuk tomuk. Amar data to upor teoluke AI kori lobo. Kori metrical or abila korosot 800 service or reference sahijabo. Medical or prot 800 service or kagojahijabo. Japna look interview tahok, amar 800. So livelihood and employment generation is one of our priority. Aru moi babuja will see lot of positive movement on that also in 2022.
Nationally, the trend is that government is withdrawing from businesses, whereas in Assam we have seen you are increasing your sphere of influence. Is this towards the 10% GDP addition, yes, which you are planning, or is it something to do more of an emotional connect, or does it make a business sense, like to increase the sphere of influence which you are presently doing?
So we have increased our share only in Assam Accord-based refinery, that is NRL, because NRL is very, very emotive to the people of Assam. But we also see a business there. If you see Singapore government, their revenue comes 50% from the tax, 50% from the shares or the investment they made. So Assam government has taken two very, very crucial decisions. To invest in NRL, that will give us leeway of around 700 to 800 crores of dividend annually after few years. Namro fertilizer, we see lot of business there. That is why we have decided to increase 26%. We are also taking another big step of bringing all our profit making petrochemicals PSU under one holding company, so that we can unlock the value of our investment. Gujarat Petrochemicals, being one holding company, they have unlocked their potential. We have Assam Gas Company, we have NTPC, we have our shares in Purva Bharati, we have our share in petrochemicals, gas cracker. But this is bit and bit. we want to bring all this investment in one holding company so that holding company itself becomes strong of 50,000 crores. So we are restructuring our resources to unlock it for the benefit of people of Assam.
Mr. Chief, হেই হত্তাটো কেনেকে আগুৱাই লৈ যাব
সক প্ৰথম কথাটো হল যদি জাতিটুক আগুৱাই লৈ যাব লাগে সাকৰিমুখী মানসিকতাৰ পৰা জাতিটুক দূৰত নিব লাগিব আজি অসম গৰ্মেন্ট হেজ গিভেন এমপ্লয়মেন্ট কিন্তু যদি গৰ্মেন্টে অকল এমপ্লয়মেন্টৰ সোর্স হয় তেতিয়া হলে আমি এটা সময়ত ৰখি যাব লাগিব সেইকাৰণে সেলফ সাফিচিয়েন্সি ইন এগ্ৰিকালচাৰ এম এছ এম ই মুভমেণ্ট স্কিল এই গোটেইবিলাকৰ ওপৰত আমাৰ বহুত বেছি ফ'কাছ আছে আৰু মই ভাবোঁ যে আনএমপ্লয়মেণ্ট প্ৰব্লেম উইল বি এবল টু টেকেল কাৰণ উইথ গ্ৰ'থ অপৰচুনিটি কাম যদি অসমৰ 10% ইকনমিক গ্ৰ'থ এভৰি ইয়েৰ হয় দেন উইল বি এবল টু এবজৰ্ভ দ্য আনএমপ্লয়ড ইউথ ইন ভেৰিয়াছ বিজনেচেছ এণ্ড ভেৰিয়াছ এক্টিভিটিজ Important thing is that economy need to grow. We are growing. So that gives you a hope.
Mr. Pranada.
So, Ohomia Bhakha APSC Ketiao Nasili. Ohomia Bhakha compulsory APSC Hobolage Buli Kuno Ain Ketiao Kotu Nasili. এইবাৰ আমি পৰীক্ষামূলকভাৱে তাক প্ৰৱৰ্তন কৰিছিলোঁ এটা মানুহৰ মাজত এটা ভুল ধাৰণা দিয়া হৈছে যেন কোনোবাই অসমীয়া ভাষা কম্পালচৰি এছিএছত আগত কৰি ৰাখিছিল ষ্টেট গভৰ্ণমেণ্টে এইটো চেঞ্জ কৰিছিল প্ৰথমবাৰৰ পৰীক্ষাত আমি পৰীক্ষামূলকভাৱে সেইটো কৰাৰ চেষ্টা কৰিছিলোঁ বাট ইট লিডছ টু লট অফ কমপ্লিকেশ্যন আমাৰ অসমীয়া ল'ৰাবিলাকে আহি আপত্তি কৰে যে আমি ইংলিছ মিডিয়ামত পঢ়িলোঁ দাদা এতিয়া আমি চাকৰি নকৰিম নেকি গতিকে এটা যিটো ধাৰণা দিয়া হৈছে যেন কোনোবা তৰুণ গগৈ দিনতো অসমীয়া আছিলে সৰ্বানন্দ সোণোৱালৰ দিনতো অসমীয়া আছিলে এইটো নহয় এই পাৰ্টিকুলাৰ বেটছটোৰ ক্ষেত্ৰতহে এইটো প্ৰৱৰ্তন কৰা হৈছিল নহয় তেওঁলোকৰ ডেট ইজ দ্য ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট থিং অসমীয়া মাধ্যমৰ ল'ৰা ছোৱালীৰ কাৰণে প্ৰথমবাৰৰ বাবে অসম চৰকাৰে সিদ্ধান্ত লৈছে যে তেওঁলোকে এইবাৰৰ পৰা অসমীয়াতে পৰীক্ষা দিব পাৰিব আমাৰ মানুহৰ মাইণ্ডটো দুই ধৰণে যায় মই যেতিয়া মেডিকেল ইঞ্জিনিয়াৰিঙৰ কোৰ্চটো অসমীয়া কৰিব খোজোঁ একেজন মানুহে আৰ্টিকল লিখি দিয়ে যে এওঁ কি ডাক্তৰ বনাব খুজিছে আকৌ অসমীয়াটো যদি আউট অফ দিছ আমি কওঁ কম্পালচৰি অসমীয়া দিব নালাগে তেতিয়া কওঁ অসমীয়া ভাষাৰ ওপৰত প্ৰহাৰ কৰিলে কথাটো হ'ল যে অসমীয়া মিডিয়ামত পঢ়া ল'ৰাখিনিক আপোনালোকে আগুৱাই যোৱাৰ